PMI Annotation. ZW3D 2016 provides a whole new 3D annotation named PMI, Product Manufacturing Information. This is the PMI ribbon toolbar. Designers can create 3D dimensions or annotations on a model. They will be listed in the View Manager. Firstly, let's activate some views to store PMI. For this model, let's select the top view first, then set the PMI dimension attribute. With Quick Dimension, create various 3D dimensions. Now, pick the point to create a length dimension in the X direction. Pick the circle center to define the distance between the centers. Pick the edges to get the whole length. Next, continue to create a width dimension in the Y direction. Pick the point, edge, or face to create the needed dimension. This is a width dimension between centers. Now, many dimensions are created in the top view. Drag it to adjust the position. If the dimension sizes are not the same, then resize the PMI. You will get a better display. If you want to move some dimensions to another view, right-click on dimension and click Attach to assign it to the other view. At the same time, you could change settings to only display PMI in the active view. Next, let's continue to add some dimensions. Pick circle and bottom face to create the height dimension of a hole. Pick the point and bottom face to get the total height. Then, let's apply the radius diametric tool to create a radius dimension. You can also do this with quick dimension to define the radius dimension. So far, the 3D dimensions are finished. Next, we need to create the needed annotations. Firstly, define a datum. Pick the bottom face, define the location point and plane. Secondly, create a feature control symbol. After the concentricity symbol and tolerance information, then assign location point. Repeat it to create another one. After the concentricity symbol and tolerance information, then assign location point. Next, create a surface finish symbol. Set the base point, symbol type, and value to finish. Then let's create two coordinate label dimensions. Pick the point and location to finish. Repeat. Last, add a label for the whole feature. Number by the diameter value through hole. So far, all 3D annotations are finished. Resize PMI to optimize the display. And show all PMI. Open a different view to check again. This is the top view. This is the front view. open up the isometric view. Last, let's create a 2D sheet. Lay out the standard view. Here is a new option, Inherit PMI. The default view is the top view, and the projection is the front view. You can see that all related PMI are linked with the corresponding view. The new PMI function allows designers to intuitively create 3D annotations, and PMI can be inherited in any 2D drawing as well.